You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Friday, May 7th, 2021. All week, we have been talking about those objects that we see in our church every week, but we might not really understand why they are there or even what they're called. So this week, we spent time talking about the tabernacle, chalice, paten, ciborium, pyx, finger bowl, cruets, the altar cloth, and the corporal. So that's a lot of words. That's probably enough new words for you this week. So we're going to end this week by just pondering this question. Why are our churches, like the building and even the windows, and then all of the objects in our churches, like the chalice and the paten and the tabernacle and the altar, why are they so beautiful, so fancy, so different than the ordinary objects that we use every day? Chances are, if you're sitting and eating breakfast right now, that the cup you're drinking out of is very different than the chalice that you see the priest use at Mass. Also, the walls of your home are probably very different than the walls and windows of your church. Now, why is that? There's lots of reasons, but what I want you to think about today is this. God is good. God is good. All good things come from God. We know that He is love, that He is life, and that He also is the author of beauty. Everything He does is beautiful. Even if you have ever, you know, looked at the wings of a butterfly or looked at a cell under a microscope, you can see that everything that God has created is interesting and beautiful and so wonderfully made. So when we go to worship God, of course, we can never create anything like He created. We are so far beneath Him. But we want to create something that draws our mind to God, that allows us to sit there and bask in the beauty, because we are there to worship the author of all that is beautiful. In my church, we have an incredibly beautiful ceiling. It is just an ornate and lots of gold, and there's all these little flowers. I mean, it's the most beautiful ceiling I've ever seen. And someone spent a long time putting that together, all those little details on this giant, very, very high ceiling. Now, some people might say that's a big waste of time. They should be out. You know, Judas would say, you shouldn't have spent that money on that or your time. You should be out serving the poor. And yes, serving the poor is good, but also honoring God and creating a place where I walk in, my heart is instantly lifted to God because I am just overwhelmed by the beauty of where I am. That's important too. And so we're going to continue talking for the next couple weeks about these objects that we see at Mass. We're going to talk about the priest's vestments, about statues and the Stations of the Cross on the wall and all those things that we see, don't really understand why they're there. We're going to keep talking about them. But in each of these situations, we're talking about something that is unique, that is set apart, that's so different than ordinary life. You know, you don't see people walking down the street dressed like a priest with all the vestments. What they're wearing is different, and it's different for a reason. So we're going to continue to talk about that. But all week long, we've been talking about things, and I've told you to notice them when you go to church this weekend. So just a reminder, here's what to keep your eyes open for this week. First of all, the tabernacle. Look at it. Why is it beautiful? Also notice the chalice, which is the large cup, the paten, which is the plate that the Eucharist will be on, and the ciborium, the large bowl that Christ is placed into. and then put into the tabernacle. Also notice the finger bowl when the priest washes his hands, the cruets, which has the water and wine in it, and a pyx. You might not see a pyx because those are sometimes hard to spot because people just have them. Also notice the altar cloth and watch your priest carefully lay out the corporal, the small cloth in the center of the altar where he will say the prayers of consecration. So notice those things, and I hope that they help you believe even more fully that this truly is the body and blood of Jesus Christ, his body, blood, soul, and divinity present at each and every Mass.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
We are enrolling new families in our Domestic Church Project Boot Camp right now, which is accessed through the app. If you would like to go with us live through this experience and transform your family and really embrace your role as a primary educator of faith in your home, please join us. We will just be enrolling families this week, and then we'll be prayerfully kicking off this experience together. To find a direct link to join us, just check the notes for this podcast episode.
This show is a production of the Spoke Street Media Podcast Network. For more great podcasts, visit SpokeStreet.com.